Fight Club John told me one day, he said, yo, DMC's the only MC that could take positivity and make it more powerful than any gangster. Mm. And I was like, what do you mean by that? You rapped about Christmas in Hollis.
It's Christmas time in Hollis, Queens.
You rapped about chicken and collard greens.
Mom's cooking chicken and collard greens.
You rapped about St. John's University.
I'm DMC in the place to be. I go to St. John's University.
And that was more powerful than any gangster rap. And I was like, wow, I never knew that.
Straight to college, I'm like,
the kids need to know at this level now, while they're young, while their muscles are still forming, while their brains are full of power and energy, this is when you start to change the world. Hip-hop didn't just create rappers. Like, this generation of young people think, man, hip-hop, I'm gonna be a rapper. But hip-hop created journalists, writers, directors, educators, designers, scientists, so much more. The hip-hop that you hear on radio and see on TV, it's probably only 2%.
Running through these checks till I pass out. This shorty give me neck till I pass out. I swear to God, all I do is cash out.
There's a lot of kids, when they hear me speak, they go, Mr. DMC, with all due respect, you 50 years old, you wise and intelligent, you pioneer, you've been here for a long time. And I go, that's true, young brother or sister, but I was 18 when I changed the world.
The rhymes we say to set a trend, because a devastating rap is what we say. Now I want everybody out there to put their hands up like my man DMD.
Speaking about hip-hop, you know, it changed the culture of the world.
Now, young people, you see a lot of people who have dread, you know, go to a tanning shop, get enough dark skin.
Many of the hip-hop artists, they work together.
Yo, we're not here to freak, because we're not ministers.
You didn't see that during the rhythm and blues era where, you know, you had a couple artists that worked together, but you might see, I mean, there was a record called something about destruction. You
self-destruction. Well, today's topic, self-destruction, it really ain't the rap audience that's bugging. It's one or two suckers, ignorant brothers, trying to rob and steal from one another. You get caught in the mid, so to crush that stereotype, here's what we did.
Self-destruction, yes.
Yeah. Well, was that a great one?
Yeah, it was great.
I love the message that was in hip-hop.
The way we live is positive, we don't kill our relatives.
Well, we had a good run, you know, Huff and myself and all the Tom
marvelous
run. We had a good run. In fact, we had sampled a couple of records years before hip-hop came in. I don't know if you remember a record called Billy Paul Letterman.
Someone's knocking at your door, somebody's ringing the bell. Do me a favor, open the door, and let me.
Old Paul McCartney record. We used Malcolm X's speech.
I say, you've been misled, you've been had, you've been took.
We used Dick Gregory's speech.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by the Creator with certain inalienable rights.
And Martin Luther King.
I will go out to you and transform dark yesterdays into bright tomorrows. With this faith, we will be able to achieve this new day.
That was hip hop.
Before hip hop. This was it. Well, hip hop probably was just brewing at that time.
And sing with the Negroes in the spiritual world. Free at last.
What I like about hip hop is that they took a lot of our records and sampled them.
Yes, indeed.
You know, that kept us in the game a little bit, you know.
A lot of people don't know, if it wasn't for musicians, there would be no hip-hop. The reason why hip-hop was able to get noticed, because the music that we did sample or steal from these guys was already great.
Speak to the rhyme of the rhyme I just made.
It wasn't that we were just celebrities. When we walked the red carpets, people never asked us, who's your designer? Who you dating? Who's your stylist? They would say, why are you young people using the music you're using and saying what you're saying?
Once we were awakened, you see, once we were awakened, we said, hey, listen, let's go back into the community. And what we were able to do is take all the vacant lots, the abandoned houses, and rebuild. We had a song we did years ago called Clean Up the Ghetto.
You can no longer depend on the man downtown to take care of business like he's supposed to, when he's supposed to. In order for us to get it like it's supposed to be, as far as cleanliness, you know, and safety, we got to get together and do it for ourselves.
And Clean Up the Ghetto was about African people going back into their own communities, cleaning up their own community. You must have your own territory. A good example of having your own territory is Chinatown.
Yeah. We in the international district, oh. Chinatown, you know how it goes. Hey. Spot for the Asians, you
it don't get no better.
You got Chinatowns just about in every city in America. And what happens is when you go to Chinatown, you see their culture. They have businesses. They have export, import. And so that's what we need to do. We need to start thinking about, stop begging people to do something for us and do things for ourselves and develop our own culture.
Wake up! Take the pillow from your head and put a book in it!
Education is about empowering yourself physically, mentally, and spiritually to the utmost of your ability. And then when you express your power, you don't just change your life, you change the world.
That in the school is ebony. African history should be pumped up steadily, but it's not. And this has got to stop.
Once you get an education, then you don't really have to work for nobody if you don't want to. You can work for yourself. And that's the theory that we're working on, is that you got to do for yourself and accept your own people. Go back into your own community.
This is my little office spot right here.
The MTV Cribs is cool, but it shows results. It doesn't show process. So these kids see a crib and their rappers living in gated communities and their kids going to the best schools. And then I gotta tell the kids, but you still living in the hood. So how do I get to that, Mr. DMC? Do I become a basketball player, a rapper, a drug dealer? I said, no, you gonna get a piece of paper that says you know something and you show that to somebody and that'll take you everywhere you wanna go. They think that the old school hip hop Run-D.M.C. Public Enemy. LL Cool J. They think we started doing what we were doing as grown men. They don't know. We changed. We didn't just make records and make money and show business. We changed the world when we were your age.
Wow.
And when you tell a kid they have the potential to do that, they say, really? And they'll leave out the next day and go down that path.